Alright, welcome back to today's video. Today is the review and tasting of the 2019 Smoked Meat Demi Glace Sauce Main, menu number 10, Canadian IMP. So the smoked meat is now in the hot water, the retort pouch is in the boiling water waiting to reheat. So we're going to start with some of the accessories, namely, first off today, Mr. Haburger bun. Alright, looks like it's in decent shape. Take off the do not eat. Well, it's a pretty dark brown for the Haburger bun. You can see how the cut is. You can see it sliced well through, but not all the way. I'm gonna bring out a different knife today. This is a knife from my late teenage years. This is my Ration old timer. So if it was from my teenage years, that's gonna put this at close on 30 to 35 years old. Been around the block a while. Still pretty good and sharp, but the blade's a little tarnished. I'll put that back in the sheath. And we'll say the Haburger bun looks just fine. With this meal, as I mentioned in the unboxing, there is no jam, there is no jelly, so really the only thing to put on to the bun would be the smoked meat with demi glaze, unless you want to get creative and perhaps put, say, the date square in the middle of that, which looks kind of awkward. Let's get the date square out as well. Two tear notches, which is kind of irrelevant for this because it's not a sauce product, but it's in the same generic packaging as the entrees these days. I'm going to take a rip there. This looks like it's in pretty good shape. I can hear CT, Canadian Trucker, licking his lips right now. I know he likes these. That looks like it's in really good shape. One of the best ones I've had so far. Next one, we've got peanut butter and banana trail mix. Let's see if we get a hiss. Yeah, there was a hiss when the tear came to that end, I think. Well, that's different. There's a whole bunch of banana chips in there. And a few chocolate M&Ms. So that's going to be the peanut butter M&Ms. Pardon me, peanut butter. That's Reese's Pieces. Let's get this right. There's no name branding on that, but generally that's what you're looking at is Reese's Pieces in here. So a small handful of those, a large handful of carrot chips, and then we have a Mars bar. Get that open as well. Oh, it's got a bit of bloom on it. So not sure how that was stored. I've had it for a couple of years, and I know it's been stored in reasonable room temperature, but that's quite a bit of bloom. Today is February 21st, 2022, so this is only a couple of years or less out of date. Let's get over and find that main entree, and we'll be right back. All right, so we've thoroughly heated the main up here. I'm gonna do a bit of a dance. Move these back and forth. I'm gonna put this out into the open tray here, and then we'll put it on the bun or see how she goes. It is fairly saucy and it's full to the top, so I'm not going to open on the second notch. I'm going to open on the top notch first. I should say I'm going to try and open it on the top notch. That one, no dice. That one, no dice. Bring the teeth into play. There we go. Okay. Oh, lovely. Smell the meat right away. Oops. That's called smoked meat, but the most common comparison is corned beef, and there is a difference between them. I'm not a connoisseur to know the difference, but they're very similar. This is one large slab of slices. Look at that. Wow. Looks, smells delicious. Certainly heated through and saucy. Now the other option for these is mustard sauce, which is a different beast unto itself, but that, you can see, is a good looking amount of meat. We're going to put that up onto the bun here shortly, but first, let's use the little wipe here, do a bit of cleanup. So I'll put some of this up onto the bun. There we go. Put some more on this edge. I'm going to take the gravy, I suppose you'd call it. And so there's no hot sauce either with this, as you now think of it. It's just the meat and the meat sauce. And like we mentioned, there's no peanut butter. There's no jelly. Let that soak into the bun for a moment. Flip that round. Now, That is a good looking little bun. We'll take a good solid bite of that. I'll be right back. Mmm. Delicious. So that first bite was absolutely delicious. I'm going to take the next few minutes and consume this because it's my lunch, although it's a late lunch because it's already darn near 2 o'clock today. So I'm going to consume that, likely the rest of this, and I'll come back and we'll try out the snacks, the dessert, so to speak, and then the candy bar, etc. Back shortly. Okay, so we're back. The main of the meal, the smoked meat and the bun, is eaten and done. The meat that was left over after the one stuff that I had put on the bun, when I got to the middle of that giant water clump of meat, it actually was kind of dry and kind of, I would say, kind of chewy. Not bad, but still just remarkable. So now we're going to try a random banana chip. It looks like they're still fairly crisp. Indeed they are. Sweet with a mild banana flavor. I'll try a few of these. The no-name brand Reese's Pieces, the peanut butter, not Smarties, or not peanut M&Ms, they're just the Reese's peanut butter things, just like E.T. used to love. Perfectly fine. I'd like to try this next. You can see there's lots of bloom on that. Let's run my finger now through it. You can see it does come off quite easily. I don't think there's a problem with it. Let's see if we can get it apart. The nougat is just fine inside. The chocolate is fine inside. But you can see that bloom does go well into the outer layer. Have a bite of that. Tastes fine. So from there, let's move to the date square. As I said before, this one looks like it's in really good shape. We'll see how she comes apart. Just fine, thank you. Looks good. I'm gonna take a big bite. You can see the shiny on my fingers. It's not greasy, it's just that's the liquid that comes out of it, or the moisture that comes out of it. Very sweet, very soft. Indistinct flavor. Dates are not a very strong flavored thing in the first place, but totally edible, and I'm certain that that's going to be a relatively high calorific item. From there, we're going to work up to something we can wash this down with. We'll be right back. So the next thing we've got then is the vanilla drink mix. So I'm going to try and make sure this is all down at the base of the bag, because it is sealed above the zipper top seal here. I'm going to take that, open it up as best as we can. Should do. Operative word is should. There we go. It's not quite as low as I need it to. You can see it still doesn't want to open there. I'm just going to open this off camera, back in a flash. Alright, with a pair of scissors, we made short work of that. Now we have a bag of Columbia's Finest. You can see the fine white powder down in there. There's a fill line. It says fill to there with water. I'm going to take the jug out of the fridge. And I didn't make any tricks about folding over. If you can fold the bag over at this line and put a crink in it, and that way you'll see where you are for moisture level. I'm just going by temperature feel, and that feels pretty darn close. I'm going to close that up. Still leaving air in the void, which means air in this area, because that way there's some room for it to mix up when you shake it. Fold over just to be safe. And do a whole bunch of shaking. Turn it over. There we go. I'm just going to get it in the cup and pour it out. Alright, so it should be thoroughly mixed. Pour it out into a glass here. Hopefully this has got enough volume to hold it all. I might have put a little less than what's necessary for moisture in there, just because I eyeballed the mix. And there's still some powder down in the corner, so I'm going to put some more water in there and do some more mixing. Normally these are quite well soluble. Try that now that I've mixed more. extra moisture. It might make the whole thing a little thinner than it should be, but I'm not too concerned. And it looks like you got moisture of that extra powder that was out of the corner, so that should be good to go. You can see it's pretty darn empty. And it does have the footed bottom, I should mention that. You can see it stands up on its own, so it's got the gusseted bottom area, so it does stand and can be used as its own drinking vessel. I put it in here just so you can see it. Give that a few sips. Okay, I just drank the whole thing. That is like a frothy, I won't say milkshake because it doesn't have the consistency or the flavor of it, but it is like a frothy protein drink. Easily consumable. I took the whole thing down in one set of gulps, so definitely a thumbs up on that. So the next thing we have is going to be the sports drink. So we'll open up the bag, open up the base so it stands on its own, just like that. Take one of these packages, doesn't really matter which, they're both the same. This one feels like it's fairly tightly packed, but it should be sufficient to get the majority of it into the drink mix container. Oh, it's a little bit crystallized. You see that in there? Pour it into the container and see if you can pick up on it. So that means there was some moisture in there and there was some force as it was packed down somewhat. I bet it'll still mix up just nicely. We'll save the extra one for a trade for somebody or for summertime use for myself or my boy. And we'll fill it to that magic line. Pour it close to it as we can. It's pretty close. Yep, pretty close meaning pretty exact. We'll close that up, also leaving the air void for mixing. Double check that zipper top, fold it over. You can see it's well dissolved already. There's some powder in the bottom. We'll give that some shakes, and then we'll give that a taste test. You can see that even though I had the zipper top done, there is moisture in the top, so it's a good thing I had that folded over to keep the major mess from happening. Take that and drink from this long side, this side here or this side, not these far sides. Give it a few sips. Yep. Tastes just like your orange aid type drinks you'd buy for your sports recovery. So totally passable, even though it was somewhat crystallized. Looks like it's totally dissolved. And with a bit of cool water out of the fridge, that tastes pretty darn good. So that becomes the end of this video. I'd like to say if you enjoyed the content, please like and subscribe. If you have any comments, please leave them below. Questions or commentary of any sort and criticism is fine. And hopefully we'll see you soon on the next one.